105 is the number that comes to my head. When I think of all the years I wanna be with you, wake up every morning with you in my bed. That's precisely what I plan to do. And you know one of these days, when I get my money right, buy you everything and show you all the finer things in life. We'll forever be in love, so there ain't no need to rush. But one day I won't be able to ask you loud enough. I'll say, well,
not only are we here to celebrate the new baby, we are here to join together in matrimony, James and Desiree.
Y'all didn't know y'all were coming to wait to see me. I've been having keep the secret forever.
We're here in the sight of the Almighty God and before these witnesses to join together this man and this woman. If there's any here who see any just cause that the two shall not be formally joined together in matrimony, speak now or forever hold your peace. Who give this woman away?
I do.
In doing so, you are relinquishing all of your rights and placing them gently in the hand of this man. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you for this father. We thank you for all that he has invested in this daughter. We pray, kind master, that as he place the responsibility of taking care of this woman in the hands of this man, that he would gently receive that chore and take it and only allow death to do them apart. Now, Des, I want you to kiss your father. That will be ending that relationship, and it will be starting another relationship. Marriage is a very sacred and pleasant thing for God, because in all of his creations, the first day he created the light. The second day he created the sky and the water. The third day, the dry land and the sea. The fourth day he created the moon, the sun and the stars. And on the fifth day he created the birds and the fish. And then he made all of the animals to fill the world, and then he created man. He looked at man and said, it is not good for man to be alone. He caused him to fall into a deep sleep, took one rib, and he made one woman. Beloveds, when two sacred hearts are bound together in the bond of matrimony, it is a blessed and sacred moment. We recognize that marriage was important to God, and it was in his plan. For God himself ordained the first marriage. Jesus, our Lord, when he came into the world, his first miracle was performed at a wedding. But I think it's very crucial that we understand where the rib came from. It did not come from his head, so he had no business bossing the woman around. It did not come from his foot, so he has no business placing his feet upon her. It came from his side, which means you are to come alongside of this man and bring the best out of him. Why don't you stand closer together? Because the closer you stand, and with God in the center, nothing will ever break this up. Beloveds, the Bible speaks of how we should submit one to another. The Bible says, as Christ is the head of the church, even so the man is the head of the woman. He said that you should submit yourself to your own man as unto the Lord. He said, husbands, love your wife, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it. For this cause shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and they too shall become one flesh. I believe if we want to see the beauty of love, I believe it's described in 1 Corinthians chapter 15. of chapter 13. Let me just share what the Bible says. He said that love is patient. It's kind. It's never jealous, nor envy, nor boastful, nor proud, never haughty, nor selfish. Love does not demand its own. It is not irrational. It's not touchy. Does not hold grudges and hardly see the wrong that others do. He says the greatest of the three is love. We are about to take vows before the Almighty God. But before you guys take your vows, I'd like this audience to take theirs. If you're here to support Desiree, I ask that you stand and repeat these vows after me. If you're here to support Desiree, as loved ones and friends, I vow to continue to pray for them. I also vow to give advice only when I'm asked. I vow to keep all of my negativeness to myself as long as we live. If so, say, I do.
I do.
If you're here for James, I ask that you stand up and repeat these vows. As loved ones and friends of James, I continue to pray for them. I also vow to give advice only when I'm asked. I will always keep all of my negative opinions to myself. If so, say, I do.
I do.
Father, you heard the vows of these family. This family, we pray, kind master, that they would do exactly what they've said, a vow to do. Not just before us, but before you. And we'll be very careful to give you praise, honor, and glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. So you, James Glenn, take Desi, signifying your love for her in the bond of matrimony. Do you promise, will you take her to be your lawful wedded wife before God and before these witnesses present? Do you promise to love her, to honor her, to cherish her, to leave all others, and to cleave only to her as a husband as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I do. Desiree, do you take this man to be your lawful wedded husband before God and before these witness present? Do you promise to love him, to honor him, to cherish him, to leave all others, to cleave only to him and to him only, and to be faithful wife unto him as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I do. Lord, we love you. And thank you for smiling down on them. We pray, Father, that nothing or nobody would ever separate these two, nothing but death. So, Lord, will you look now and will you seal this? Will you forgive them for any sin that was committed prior to this? Would you love them as your dear children? And we'll be very careful to give you honor, praise, and glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
So,
with this ring,
I do wed. With loyal love,
to endure all my earthly goods,
and to live with her until death do us part. In the name of the Father, the name of the Son, and the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Take this ring. Push it on.
If it goes.
That's swollen. The way it is, you put that ring on his finger, Des, and you hold it there. With this ring,
I do wed.
My loyal love to thee. To share all of my earthly goods. In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The name of the Son.
In the name of the Holy Spirit.
With the power that is invested in me as a gospel minister, I'd like to present to you.
I swear that I don't mean it. I swear that I don't mean
it.
I say,
congratulate you. I am
so proud of both of you. I'm very excited about the life that is about to take place. I wish you the best, and I can't wait for that little grandbaby to come. Love you guys.
So I just want to say that I love you all both so, so much, and I'm so, so proud that you all have made this step. That means your family will be united together forever, as long as you all have an opportunity to love each other, grow that baby, and grow each other. You're going to make a wonderful couple, and we're so, so very proud of you. So we love you. Mwah! To both of you.
Well, first, we'd like to take the time to thank James and Dez for being such a great couple. We appreciate them so much, and we realize the importance of marriage. We understand that marriage is designed to complete, not to compete. So we pray that they are together, that they might be able to complete one another. God bless you, son. Daddy love you.
As a mom, I knew what kind of wife I wanted for James. I knew what James needed. And much prayer to God, I knew that he would make it complete. So we're so thankful for Desiree, because she's the kind of bride I would want for James. She's the kind of bride that James needs. And we thank God, and we pray for many years for this union. And we're going to ask your continued prayer as we wait on baby Piper to be born.
I'd like to say that your grandmother and I are very happy. You were our first granddaughter, and you're giving us our first great-granddaughter. We're really proud. Thank you very much.
Keep your marriage shaken, not stirred.
Tears to the Glenn family. I'm proud of you, boy. You surprised me. I'm glad you surprised me, because I think this is the best thing that you could have ever done. You have a great woman in your life, and I think that she'll always be there for you by your side. You should do the same for her. Times will come where you look at her and say, why? But at the best time, you know that's the best thing that will ever happen to you. Congratulations to the both of you guys. May God bless both of you.
Congratulations, Desiree and James. I want to... And Piper, yes. I want to wish you best wishes with all the exciting new adventures you guys are going to have. I'm so excited. Can't wait to hear all the stories from Washington, from you guys here in Texas.
Congrats, I'm so, so happy, the best, and I'm looking forward to sharing many, many, many more good memories.
My name is Betty Osborne, James' grandmother. Congratulate them and be together for the rest of their lives.
Congratulations, James, Mrs. and Mr. James Glenn, and Desiree. Anyway, I'm very proud of y'all. Thank y'all for the invite. Always put God first, and you guys will survive anything that comes your way. I promise you, this year will be going on 19 years, and I'm loving it. Still love my spouse. Always, just always put God first in whatever that you do. Love both of y'all, and again, thank you so very much for making me a part of this happy occasion. Thank you.
James and Desiree, just want to tell you all congratulations, Sonia and I.
We are so proud of you. You've done the right thing. God is looking down on you. Bless both of you and little Kipperay.
Hi, Desiree and James. We are so thrilled to be here today for your baby shower. And then you surprised the darn dickens out of us with the wedding. But we are thrilled for both of you. You're a pair that's made in heaven. We love you, and we're proud of both of you. Pop-Pop and Grandma and Great-Grandma.
James, we're happy for you guys. Congratulations.
Congrats, James, from Jessica and Ellie.
Congratulations! Can't wait to meet Piper.
Congratulations, you guys. We're happy for you.
Hi. Congratulations, Desiree and James. So happy for you guys. Can't wait to meet Piper, James. You guys will be awesome parents.
Hi, guys. I love you both. Can't wait to meet baby Piper Ray. Thank you.
This was absolutely the most amazing baby shower / wedding. I think the reaction on everybody's face was priceless, and I wish you guys all the success. I hope that you guys stay in love forever and be good to each other. You guys look great together, and like I said, all the success in the world. Love you guys.
I just want to say I love you guys. Congratulations. I can't wait to meet Piper Ray, and many blessings.
Hi, James and Desiree. I want to say congratulations on your new bundle of joy and of your matrimony. Have many blessed years together, and congrats.
I would just like to say congratulations to you, James and Desiree. I hope you have a long life with the baby and your marriage. Love you.
congratulations, James and Desiree. I'm so happy for y'all. And also, I'm excited to see Piper. So, congratulations.
Congratulations, Jay Boo, man. Keep that woman happy, brother.
Wake up every morning with you in my bed. That's precisely what I plan to do. Oh, love, love is a feeling that you feel. But if you open up, no, I won't let you fall, my dear. Under the surface, we're all just the same. Follow me, darling, for you I'll be brave. Oh, love, love is a feeling that you feel.
I just want to say thank you to everyone who came. This seriously was the most amazing experience I have had so far in my life. Everything's beautiful, and I got to share such a special moment with all of my family and my friends and the crazy people. But I just want to say thank you, and I love everybody, so thank you.
Just the same, follow me, darling, for you I'll be brave, oh love. When will you lend yourself to me? Take your time, I'll be here waiting for you. I won't let you go when your world's in the dark. You can't keep up in my heart. Even your fear will keep us apart. You can't keep up in my heart.
From the cake, pops, and apples. I thought that was pretty creative.